Welcome to another episode of Carbs, the only show where I sit in the car and BS while consuming carbs. Matt Zion here. We have back-to-back Wiener Schnitzel reviews. They actually have three new items, but one of them I think is a little bit redundant, so there's no real reason for me to do them both. But they brought out Oozfest, which I think they've done this before, and I don't even know if I've done these reviews before. But we're going to go ahead, we're going to jump right into it, because why the hell not? We need content, and fast food releases are so rare these days. But before we get into that, I got a question for you. I'm so curious about this. I'm sitting across the street from a Costco gas store, or a gas station gas store. And, like, they always line up. Like, they have got to be in that line for at least 15 minutes from the back to actually getting gas pumped in there. Is it actually, like, worth the money you're saving by waiting in line for gas? Like, I feel like, and maybe I'm a weird person here, but I'm gonna ask your opinion on this as well. I won't judge you. I value my time more than I value money. Now, that's not to say that money is not important, because clearly you have to have money in order to get more time. My point is, I will spend a little bit more to go into a gas station that's empty just to get the gas over with so I can enjoy my day and enjoy my life, as opposed to waiting, you know, 15, 20 minutes to get gas a little bit cheaper. Like, is that a weird thing to say? Or do you agree, disagree? Let's have a discussion down below. So, first thing we're gonna be doing today is the double cheese chili fries, a harmonious blend of melty cheese sauce, shredded cheddar cheese, and the Wiener Schnitzel's chili. So there you go. By the way, these descriptions are from frozenfoodsbiz.com. Man, all of these websites now are trying to get you to agree to using tracking cookies or just the internet cookies. It's weird. It feels like the corporations are like trying to get whatever they can before November. And if that makes any sense, even though I think really we're all gonna lose in November regardless of who actually, you know, becomes president. But it feels like the corporations are, like, desperately attempting to get whatever they can. Ooh, there's a lot of cheese on here. I don't think this is gonna be anything super special, but I think it's gonna hit the spot. I am hungry as hell. I have not eaten yet today. And I did watch a couple of decent things on Netflix. I finally got around, actually it wasn't Netflix, I think it was on Hulu, but I watched Parasite, fantastic film. Usually I don't like foreign films, but I really enjoyed Parasite quite a bit. Probably the best movie I've ever seen that didn't have any characters that were likable. They're all just miserable people overall, and but yet it was fantastic. It deserved all the Oscar nods that it got. It won, right? I think it won. And then I watched Hashtag Alive, which is a South Korean zombie movie. It was good. It had a lot of, like, holes in it. Like, a dude's, like, for 20 days, he's stuck in his apartment, and he's, like, running out of water, and he's like, I have no food, I have no water, and yet he's clean-shaven, and his hair's taken care of, and he looks beautiful. That was a little stupid, but it was still a fun movie. It was worth the view. And then I think the other one I watched was Freaks? I think it was called Freaks, or something like that, but it was on Netflix. It's a German film about superheroes, and I called it was like if you got discount X-Men without the budget. that's what it was. It was low budget X-Men, but it, you know what, it was fine. Electro Man that was in it was my favorite character there. All right, on to the business. Let's go. Oh, this cheese is so thick. Total opposite of my penis. Okay. Oh, look at that. This bite's gonna be fantastic. Hey, twitch.tv/recklesseating, give us a follow. Let's go. Cheese is excellent. Cheese is so good. It is that cheap cheese. It tastes like the stuff that you would get out of the can back in the day. But nostalgia. Yes, I did eat that stuff a lot. So that's cool with me. Chili seems fine. I've always said before, I'm not a gigantic fan of chili. I don't hate it, but it's just not one of my go-tos. The fries themselves are just so, like, I don't know. The fries are a little weak overall. I wish they had a little more girth to them. I've also heard that on my dating life. All right. Yeah, these are not, you know what? These are stoner food. I mean, that's what it is. This is something that I would almost expect to get from Jack in the Box, which is essentially like stoner heaven. But it's not bad at all. And the price point's fine. I think I only paid, $6 for the fries and for the hot dog we're gonna do tomorrow? Yeah, I mean, it's not bad. It all meshes very well together, too. You don't get the chili standing out above the cheese or the fries. Everybody's working together. the opposite of the United States of America right now. What a shithole 2020 is. I bet 2021 is going to be way worse too, and we won't even see it coming. I think the flavors all work together. I don't have any major complaints other than, I mean, it is what it is. It's a very simplistic version. It's almost like you could make that if you just, you know, had the time and patience to do it at home and had the ingredients. But for the price point, the convenience factor, I'm going to rate that a solid 4 out of 5 matte faces. Pretty decent overall. Wiener Schnitzel continuing to be one of the few fast food chains that is constantly releasing new content. And also, I fucked up because I parked in front of a Tommy's, which is ironically also Chili, and now the line is forming behind me, and I think I'm actually stuck here. So I've got one more review. Hopefully it clears up before then. Thank you for watching. We'll see you soon. Bye. He's fat!